game's up. You're surrounded. Come out with your hands on your head.
Goddamn. I need a drink.
Good afternoon, boys and girls. How you doing? It's the Hairy Jobbie podcast. It's Sunday afternoon, and with me today, the owner, the owner and proprietor of the Hairy Jobbie, Mr. Colin Liddell, with us.
How?
Just like that. That's how we do it. We've just finished watching the Rangers versus Hibernian match on Sunday, 11th of August, 2019, and I was much, much impressed. Big man, what's your thoughts on just straight after the match?
Oh, just honestly, conditions were horrible. You can hear the rain battering off the roof and battering in the roof. You need to get some Isoflex for the... Honestly, the water is running in the shuck of my arse here. Oh, I've started to build an ark.
Really?
And gather animals to be two. This is Armageddon, by the way.
It is biblical. It really is biblical. It's a bit mental out there. What was it you tweeted straight after the game today? You put a couple of tweets out there on the Hairy Jobbie, at the Hairy Jobbie on Twitter.
I could have watched another hour.
I could have watched another hour of that. I absolutely agree with you, mate. That's what I could have done. I thought that was an absolutely fantastic performance for Rangers today. Now, we wouldn't have won this game last year.
No.
I said that during the game.
We would have puffed. We would have... Tavernier would have had his shots where the keeper made worldies, and yeah, we would not have capitalised.
Yep,
this year, totally different, Ian.
Oofed. Is it the Stevie Gerrard effect? Is it Stevie Gerrard is just making these players better?
Well, you have to say he is making players better.
Absolutely.
We've had guys like Warburton, we've had guys like McCoist who are both players, but did they necessarily make people better?
No.
Did they make them move to that next level? I think we have got a manager and a management team that are making players excel.
Yeah. Again, majority of them free signings excel.
Well, I did do another tweet going, Ryan, who? Because Jordan Jones today was outstanding. Mm. Now, he's running, he was like he was like an NFL player, he was gathering yards, he was beating players, he was getting his throw-ins at really good portions of the park, he was winning his corner kicks, he was winning his free kicks that should have been a penalty, just... awesome today.
Yep.
And he was setting up goals.
Aye, it was absolutely superb performance. Jordan Jones, the Hairy Jobbie takes their hat off to you today, mate.
But he wasn't the Hairy Jobbie man of the match.
He wasn't the Hairy Jobbie, I was just going to get to. The Hairy Jobbie picked another man today. The only other Ryan that really matters at Rangers now is Ryan Jack. The man was absolutely outstanding today. I don't know where he pulls his performances out of nowhere sometimes, and again, I think always the bigger teams. I think Ryan Jack plays better against Hibs and Celtic and Aberdeen than he plays against St Mirren and Kilmarnock and the weird teams. But it's something that he's adding to his game where he can up his game. I think playing with Stevie Davis really helps him. But I think
again,
Aribo.
I said today, Hairy Jobbie prediction, Stephen Davis will be the Scottish player of the year this year.
Yep, you said that. Absolutely said that.
And I'll stand by it. Honestly, I just think the guy is a Rolls Royce player, and he's just so frugal with the ball. He'll no hold on to the ball if he doesn't need it. He'll no pass when he doesn't need it. He just does the easy thing well, Ian.
Yeah, I agree. Absolutely agree, mate. I'm super impressed. I'm just go back to the beginning of the game here because it was an action packed game. Much for Rangers said 3 minutes in here. A great ball over the top, but Goldson into pass to Defoe, who was just unable to bring the ball under control. A positive start for Rangers. What a ball. What a dig for a centre-half into a striker. And again, marked with two men and pulled the ball down in the box. And Jermaine Defoe in any other game, that'd have been a goal. 3 minutes
he
in.
He was just getting his shooting boots.
Yeah.
You know, he was just a golfer just working at his swing at that point.
Aye. Big Goldson pinging a ball. And I mean, he pinged it. But when we say he pinged it, he didn't just float the ball in. He absolutely drilled it straight in. And we weren't getting passes like that for defenders. Even last season, Goldson, we know, is a really good defender. But I think he's getting a lot more time and space on the ball now this season to be able to pick these passes. And I think that's why we've signed Edinson as well and Big Hollander, because they two boys, not only can they defend, but can they find passes. They get passes out.
Edinson can certainly find a pass.
Oof. I've been super impressed with that boy. Absolutely super impressed. I'm buzzing, man. Absolutely. They boys kind of get in this side at the minute, and you see why.
Well, I think they will get in their side Thursday, Sunday.
Yeah.
You know, it's going to be a long season.
Yeah. He made three changes. Steven Gerrard made three changes to the team today. Out went Arfield, Morelos, and who else went out? Midfield. I can't mind. It'll come back to me. And Davis come in, and Ojo come in, and Defoe come in.
Ojo,
yeah. And
Ojo was a change.
And he was absolutely quite right to do that today. I thought he maybe give Arfield a run the day. Game 60 minutes against the Hibs. Play with Defoe, because he loves playing with Defoe. Absolutely loves it. Uh-huh. And I thought that's the road they might actually go down. He didn't. He swapped the team around about and played Jones, Defoe and Ojo up front.
Obviously, Gerrard has got the mindset that, you know, us thinking, me, you thinking, this is a big game today.
Uh-huh.
I don't think Gerrard thought it was a big game today, and so he dropped Arfield. Because Arfield has been played, he's had the Canada thing, he's came straight in, resting.
Yeah.
And I don't, will he play on Thursday? I'm not 100% sure if I will.
I reckon you will.
Will he?
Aye.
And then rest against East Fife.
East Fife next week, he'll get a rest.
Exactly, right.
5 minutes, again, Hibs reverting to, 5 minutes into a game, Hibs reverting into what they are, a team of cluggers. Darren McGregor's booked for a late challenge in Jordan Jones. Now, I don't know what the referee's looking at there. That was a horror challenge to put in for anybody. And Iron went to his yellow card and ticketed him, but he should have been ticketed and said, just even fucking sneeze the ring away, son, and you're going to have to. That tackle could have been a red. That was a leg breaker, that one. And he got away with it. So I think this was going to be the start of the game that was going to set the tempo for the rest of the first half, because I thought Hibs early in the day were just absolutely kicking everything above grass level. And the referee let them away with it, you know.
I think the referee was thinking, conditions are playing a part. But then he booked Cattage later on.
Aye.
Which wasn't he really?
An arm across the boy's chest. Fine, fair enough. Big Cattage went, I'm not having it, but I'll fucking take it.
That's what it is.
Aye. So 9 minutes gone, and brilliant bit of football outside for Shea Ojo, who absolutely dug this shot. And we just said, as soon as we seen it hit in the back of the net, we said, we've not had a player at Rangers for at least 4 or 5 seasons now who can shoot for outside the box.
Uh-huh.
Right? And Ojo hit this 15-20, maybe 20 yards outside, because he was well outside the penalty box. 20 yards outside the box.
Fizzed
a shot in. Big Marciano, who I think was absolute Hibs man of the match today. That big keeper stopped that, been a cricket score today. Couldn't hold on to it.
Spilled it.
But it was the speed and the turn to Defoe to get in and capitalise on the rebound.
37-year-old. Yeah. 37-year-old, I think I was grunting tying my laces.
Laces? What are they?
They old Velcro.
old Velcro shoes is back. But, and that put Rangers 1 up inside 9 minutes, playing absolutely stunning football. Stunning football today.
I think the nerves, not even nerves, but I think what we thought was going to happen, happened. You know, we've had a lot of false dawns, Ian, yes. But I thought we settled into a game.
Yep.
we were just peppering.
Some of the play, some of the forward play and link-up play and passing, the one-touch passing and movement, you can see we work a lot in that. We drill that. Watched the training video for Friday again, and the coaching staff broke up the first team squad into three teams, or six teams, and then said, right, we're going to play a minute match, a two-minute match, and it's going to be the first team to make 100 passes wins. So you had to make 100 one-touch passes. Right, well, you're competing against the team that's playing next to you and the team that's playing next to you again.
That is...
And some of the football was absolutely superb to watch. And again, it creates that competition. I don't think we had competition before. We never had competition in training, competition for places. But now these, making these boys hungry. The boy that stood out for me the other day there in the training was Jake Hasty. Jake Hasty, I thought, was superb in training and couldn't get near the squad today. In training, his touch, his finishing, everything was superb. Kept an eye on him and he was absolutely fantastic. Couldn't get near the squad. So I hope Jake hangs in there.
Jake will get his chance against his five. You know, a lot of the fringe players will get that chance against that side.
Yeah.
You know, again, Greg Stewart came on today and there was a lot of people, a lot of Rangers supporters that just didn't fancy him.
Yeah.
You know, why we were getting him. I always rated the boy. Me personally, I always thought there was something in him, and I always thought he should have been at Rangers before now.
Yeah.
But even his bite and his determination today, he lost the ball.
Yeah.
Won it back. He was going for lost challenges. He was going for lost challenges and trying to just...
Mm-hmm.
I thought for this cameo... It was a great performance.
Yeah, I agree. Absolutely agree with you, mate. On 12 minutes, we had Shea Ojo booked for a missed time challenge. When you look at the McGregor tackle that he got booked for, and then it was a missed and time challenge.
The various other challenges that went on.
You have to say comparable. No, I don't think so, but... Again, that's your referee for the day. I'm not going to comment too much on him because he is a banger. 15 minutes on the clock and Jermaine Defoe pops up and makes it to a brilliant run for Jordan Jones.
Excellent.
Being two defenders, nutmegged Whittaker out on the wing. Now, if you ever want to see a player getting nutmegged, it's that fucking fry wank. I just... Watching these wee...
What I would have liked was him for the day of pirouette and nutmegged him again.
Aye.
But again, that's just piss taking.
That is piss taking. That is a piss take. I agree with you, mate. And he could have, but he didn't. He put the ball over, and then there was Weed Defoe just to dink it right in the corner, past the keeper. Big keeper, no chance. So Rangers 2-0 up on 15 minutes, and I thought this is going to be a cricket score. They're going to get a scud in the day.
Well, we thought it was. It turned out to be.
Not quite the way we thought it was going to be.
Not the way it was going to. No.
So Wee Defoe's two goals up after 15 minutes, thinking, Buff sitting on the bench, fucking fizzing. Look at him. Oh, Buff, I'm sorry, mate, but I'm off this fucking ball of the day. Just watch me, son. And you could see there was a wee bit of stuff going on. I thought Rangers were going to go on and cruise it. After 17 minutes, Big Nico got a booking for putting his arm across another fry wank in a Hibs shirt. I'm not even going to mention his name because he didn't deserve it. Should have been a Rangers player, decided to sign for them. Fuck him. We all know who we're talking about. Some of the play after that, I think it was kind of scrappy. Hibs tried to get into the game a wee bit. They tried to do a wee bit more. And again, it wasn't enough. You know, it really wasn't enough to make an impact on the Rangers team. The back four were holding steady, but Ryan Jack and Stevie Davis were falling back in and just making it really difficult for them. On the 23rd minute, a yellow card for some guy, Mackie, I take it as the wee guy that gets sent off for a dangerous challenge on Shea Ojo.
Well, it could have been a red, mate.
Could have been a red.
It was riding his luck, basically.
Yeah, absolutely was. Inept refereeing. And if this is going to be how this season is going to go, we play at Ibrox, we're going to absolutely batter teams, where referees are going to let the opposition kick us off the park. You know, I think this is going to be a pretty long season.
I'm looking at stats just now, mate, and the only stats that Hibs won were fouls. 13 for them, 8 for us.
13
you commit it, 13 fouls to our 8.
Aye. Cluggers. I was expecting a bigger game. I thought this season Hibs were playing really well and they were going to put the challenge
them to be third.
No, in that performance today. No. Absolutely not in that performance. I think they were minced today and deserve what they got. But in saying that, we said this after Thursday night's match against Midtjylland. If you come out and attack us, we're going to find spaces, we're going to break down and we're going to score.
But Ian, we were due a game against Hibs like that. You know,
yeah.
Since that game where fucking Lennon was geeing at the ears, Stokes ripped Tavernier's shirt off and Tavernier got yellow carded, that Morelos got yellow carded instead of the other guy getting sent off. Oh,
that was a terrible game. Terrible.
We were due
scudding them.
Due scudding them. And we well and truly scud at them.
Yeah.
And I'm not in the end of the season where they were beating us 3-0 and we end up beating them 3. What was that?
Drew 5 each.
5 each. We were on 5-3.
Aye.
That one as well.
Aye, they were fucking due it, Colin. You're right.
Due
it.
Due it.
Piss take.
Piss take.
Hashtag piss take. On 24 minutes, a great save for Marciano as we Tav sends a powerful free kick towards goal, right, heading towards the top corner. Big keeper dived, other hand, made it look really pretty.
Oh,
thought Ian Durant was going to piss his trousers, but big guy had got plenty to it. I was really got it with Tav the day. Get into some brilliant positions, and instead of just doing what we both done, hard and low, at the keeper, make him save it, make him miss it. Fucking fired it, trying to fire it for the top corner of the roof of the net. Had it over the bar about 4 times, keeper palmed it over the bar a couple of times, you're going, mate, it's fucking hard and low, we don't need to score worldies, you're in, you're through and goal, do your job,
aye.
Tav, pick it up, son.
Just composure.
Composure, you know what I mean, do a wee bit. Right, you could get a goal status up again this season, mate, no few penalties, right. 31 minutes, getting towards half-time, 31 minutes in, a yellow card as Vela is booked for a foul on Jordan Jones. You see the pattern going here, you see how well Jordan Jones played today? Every booking that they had was a foul on Jordan Jones. And again, we're sitting talking about Ryan Kent and gutted about Ryan Kent not coming back, and you're going, you know what? Today, I was actually really quite glad with Jordan Jones playing.
Oh.
You know, Kent's a terrific player and a wonderful lad, and his season last year will always be remembered fondly, my mate. I think we're moving on now. If we can create players, if Ryan Kent's worth anywhere the top 8 to 12 million,
uh-huh.
We want to create Jordan Jones and an 8 to 12 million pound player that's ours.
Exactly.
That's what you want to do. Get him for nothing.
Aye.
And then put him onto a bigger club, a Premier League club or something, for 8 to 12 million pounds.
But again, Jordan Jones is playing for a team who wants to play for Ian.
He is. He's a teddy bear and wants to be a teddy bear. And that's that extra 10%. When he signed for us, a lot of bears on Twitter were really sceptical about him and said, I'm not sure why. Same with the sign Kamara. That was Kamara that was missing the other night. Kamara played the other night, it wasn't playing the day. That's who played at Michelin.
Kamara was playing.
But he wasn't playing the day. Davis was back in for Kamara.
Well, Kamara wasn't. Ah, you're right. Sorry.
I knew he would come back to me. So, it just shows how good Jordan Jones was today. That every booking they picked up was on them. It was on Jordan. They deserved everything they got. Thought Jordan was absolutely amazing today. 34 minutes played. Brilliant play again for Rangers moving forward between Ojo and Aribo. And Aribo sends a shot into the side netting. I thought Aribo was quietly effective today. I think he's going to be one of these boys who's just quietly going to go about his business.
Aye, there's going to be games where he'll explode, but then there's going to be games where, as you say, just quietly go on his business. Just, you know, wee slick pass in, just watch what Davis is doing and just replicate that.
Aye. And then 2 shots inside 2 minutes for Defoe. Could have gotten his hat-trick just before half-time, but the big keeper done absolute worldies to stop him getting his hat-trick. Then in 40 minutes, we get pegged back. It had to be that fucker again, didn't it?
I've always said he will come and haunt us until he retires, Ian.
Just that he's wee dick. That wee dick of a player.
Dick of a player.
Aye. I agree with you, mate.
And again, it was a slide rule pass, but
cracking pass.
Again, flat footed, ball watching.
Yeah. Midfielder no on him. That's the first time the day that Davis never got his man.
Aye.
First time all day and he got that pass in. Good finish for the boy. Can't say anything about it, but the scoreline then at 2-1 did not reflect on the state of the game at all. So it's a wee warning call for Rangers. Teams are going to try and do this, right? So that Daryl Horgan, I'm glad he's got a number in his back, because just that name is just no right. Got him through to half time with just holding out to 2-1 down. because it could have been 5, 6, 7, 8 at half time and nobody could have complained. Fraser Murphy comes on for Hibs.
Did he?
To replace Joe Newell. I didn't know who Joe Newell was.
I didn't know Fraser Murphy. Are you sure?
Fraser Murphy.
Are you sure this happened?
Aye.
I never heard his name mentioned once.
No, it does happen, but see, when according to the channels here, the channels, back channels here are saying it definitely happened at half time.
Who came off?
Joe Newell. Fraser Murphy.
And he was playing, you say?
He was playing.
It's news to me, mate.
55 minutes played.
Now, again, what I would say is, right, in the first, the second half, Hibs came out.
It did.
They were, you know, I think Higginbottom was basically saying, right, we might have a wee bit of impetus here. Let's go and try and sneak that goal. Let's get it back. And they did. They were peppering, and they were pushing, but again, we look so strong now, Ian, that...
Yeah, no, I agree.
We don't fucking break like a wet fag anymore.
No. So they had their wee 5 minutes, and then Rangers just stepped on the gas again. And 55 minutes, Hibs were then set down to 10 men.
Oh, for Christ's sake.
Because this wee fucking Muppet called Sean Mackey was sent off for his second challenge. The first one trying to...
Oh, it wasn't a challenge.
His first one was a challenge on Jordan Jones. His second one was a...
he was doing a chicken dance, I think.
Aye. That's what
he said. His arm came up. He looked like the guy out of Carry On films when he's carrying a tray of drinks. Hey! Whoa! Again, that's for the teenagers.
Aye.
And he was raging.
Aye. He even kicked his chewing gum out, went to kick it and missed it.
No, I thought it was a spit.
No, it was his chewing gum and he kicked it out. He spit it out and went to kick it and fucking missed that and all. That tells you how good a fucking player he is.
Aye.
Ball bag, yeah, boy. Sean Mackey, ball bag. Piss take. 57 minutes. Second change for Hibs is David Gray, that fucking cunt for the cup final.
Aye.
Just haunts me. Just that skeletal look in his fucking face. Just haunts me. He come on to replace Daryl Horgan. They took a striker off and put another defender on. But then he took up against Jordan Jones and he didn't fancy it either.
No.
The move Whittaker out the other side brought David Gray on, and you'd think a defender with fresh legs against Jordan Jones would at least stand 50% maybe a chance. Nah, Jordan decided to fucking push over him and all. So, aye, deserves what he gets. 65 minutes, the ball breaks to Defoe inside the box, who sends an effort towards goal that's saved by Marciano. Again, you see how...
A pattern emerging, right?
46 minutes, Jordan Jones cuts inside in a powerful effort, tipped just over the bar for a corner. But if Hendrick deserved a goal today, Big J did. And again, I hope he gets a goal pretty soon because his play certainly deserves it. 67 minutes, final change for the visitors as Florian Camberi comes on to replace that wee fucking fanny.
Right. All right, him.
Right. And again, the boos were in the stadium when he went off because he deserves it. 68 minutes. A superb diving save for Marciano as Jones looked certain to make it 3 with a powerful effort on goal. Big keeper again, absolute worldie. Gone yourself again. 72 minutes.
Are you praising?
No, Jordan Jones.
Oh, I thought you were Jordan praising.
Jones. No, Jordan Jones, praising.
Well, I wouldn't say Jordan Jones was big.
He's not the weeest laddie, I don't think.
Against us two, he's wee.
Against us two, he's definitely fucking aye.
Yeah,
aye, he's planking the boy, I'll give him that. 72 minutes, Shea Ojo cuts in for the right wing. It's a powerful shot, deflected just wide for a corner. This is how it was second half. Didn't matter what Hibs tried today to come out and play football, they were getting absolutely drilled.
Oh,
right. And I think Rangers have got this an attack mentality, an attack mode. I think the Rangers are now trying to develop, and it's just we're just not getting teams the ball.
No,
just not doing it.
Ian, we are playing with this sort of new vision now, and we saw what we were lacking last year.
Yeah.
And where the deficiencies were, this year it's just a totally different story. And, you know, see the media who were writing off Defoe and Davis last year?
Yeah.
Fuck yous.
Oh, they're going to continue to write them off. They're going to continue.
They can't, though, Ian.
They're going to write off Ojo, they're going to write off Jordan Jones. I don't think they can write off... Oh, but they're going to try. This is the media we're talking about. You're not going to get a fair and partial media. What was it that Dick Gordon said the other night there?
About Aberdeen?
Aberdeen have got it all to do, but so have Michelin. That's a Scottish presenter on a fucking radio show.
BBC Scotland, BBC. Denmark there. Honestly, have you ever heard... Oh, I know.
Just no right. But this is what we face. And again,
I wouldn't know what... BBC Scotland say it's just word of mouth through
Twitter. We heard it on Twitter. So we did.
So it must be true.
Aye. 75 minutes gone. Substitutes starting to appear for Rangers, and Morelos and Stewart come on to replace Defoe and Jones. And again, still sitting at 3-1. You're thinking, ah, we'll get a wee goal, maybe a wee odd goal here, right? And then a superb first touch for Stevie Davis, who drives into the Hibs box and chips a wee lofted pass in the path of Jermaine Defoe, who makes it 3.
It was poor.
Absolutely superb goal. Right? 77
it
minutes.
It was deft.
It was deft.
The deft of touches by Davis.
Aye.
Only the path of Defoe. Defoe, can I just say, he looked absolutely fucking delighted.
Aye.
I know that he scored, I don't know how many hat-tricks.
Aye, that'd be an interesting stat to look up. How many hat-tricks? I'll stick that in the video. When I make the video, I'll get the stats on it. I'll stick
How
that
many
up.
Hat-tricks has Jermaine Defoe scored? But that it seemed that they all paled in the insignificance when they scored that one, mate.
Aye, I agree.
They seemed totally overcome.
Aye. Again, maybe thought he would never ever score a hat-trick again. When he moved away from Bournemouth, moved up here, thought, man, we're going to score a hat-trick again. I've got Buffalo sitting in the benches. A £20 million striker, and I'm getting my game of the day in terms of a worldie of performance. And again, see, scored a hat-trick, he could have scored 10, the boy. So he get replaced by the Buffalo come on.
Then, he didn't look very hungry, did he?
he looked hungry, all right. The boy was champing a bit. And then, 77 minutes, Buffalo just on the park, wins the ball in midfield and just runs. And he run and he took out 3 defenders and fired hard and low.
Aye.
Into the front post. He's his favourite place to put a ball. You know, you'd think keepers and that would click on you. Now. But you need that.
But you can't save them there, Ian.
No. It doesn't matter what you do.
It's just that, where that ball is going, it's
aye.
Tremendous ability by the boy.
Absolutely. So... The Buffalo's off the mark, 77 minutes. Andy Halliday comes
What score are we now? We're 4-1 now.
4-1 now. Right. Andy Halliday comes on to replace John Flanagan. I thought John Flanagan, a couple of wee silly mistakes in the first half, but Big Colin thought he had a great game.
I thought he was efficient, Ian.
Efficient, aye.
You know, again, last year against Hibs, we should have beaten every game we played,
aye.
But just couldn't break them down.
No.
At least the defence, we've slipped up once. But that was through the middle. Aye. Nothing was happening down the sides.
No, there was nothing down the sides, you know, so it's spot on. You know, one good pass through the middle. Apart from that, there was nothing going. 83 minutes, a diving save for Marciano as Tavernier went through. And again, Tav was unlucky on that one. A couple of shots today, as I said earlier on, he could have scored and should have scored. Then Andy Halliday breaks it for left back, almost makes it 5, a powerful effort in the box, saved by the keeper at the front post. But Stewart jumps in and wins the ball in the keeper's horns, takes it a yard away and fires it back in as if he's putting it back towards goal. And you go, you'd be right to get that.
No.
But he never fouled the keeper in any way. But it just shows how hungry the strikers are at our club, where you think, oh, it's a lost ball, it's a dead ball, it's in the keeper's hands there. No, it's no. I'm in for it. That boy was in the right place at the right time.
Well, Gerrard says that Stewart gives us a bit of intelligence, and You know, he lost the ball at once, but he gained it back. But he is an intelligent player, Ian.
Yeah.
And if we, when we win 55, I'm sure he'll play his part.
Absolutely will. Ryan Jack sends an effort for distance just wide of the top corner. I seen him lining it up, and I thought he doesn't know whether he dig it or bend it, and again caught in between, caught between the two.
It would have, it really would have put a seal on a tremendous performance. That Man United just scored.
But against Coopham's well humped today.
Lousy bastards. Edit this out later.
So,
if Lampard ever thought he had a hard job,
aye.
Sorry. I'm using up your tape.
My tape.
The worst it for the lane, fuck. The worst it for the fucking.
Attacking on the edge of the 18 yard box. Oft. Backy.
Is that McTominay? What's on it?
Aye. Oft. How did that bog out of there come fucking? See, if that was Rangers, we'd be pulling our hair out.
Aye, that was.
You'd absolutely be pulling our hair out.
Look what fucking came after the defender there. Right, sorry mate.
Then Wee Morelos gets his second of the game. Right on 89 minutes. I think the wee fella just absolutely delighted.
Oh.
Good on him. Again, we've not done a pod since probably the pre-season games. Oh, there's three.
Oh, 3-0. 3-0, man.
Aye, man, yeah, Rashford.
Jesus Christ.
Again, a lot of folk down south tipping them to finish 5th or 6th or even 7th in the league this season. Lucky to finish in the top 10. They sell that big Lukaku for 80 million, then, oh, we've new strikers, we've new. There you go, Frankie boy.
Frankie boy.
Fucking worried new boy. And right on 90 minutes, Shea Ojo pops up at the back stick and taps in to make it Rangers 6, Hibernian 1. And then the referee couldn't wait to blow the full time whistle because I think he was fucking drunk.
You can tell he's under crackers with a wee bit weight. You can tell he's fucking, his pain was running out. Ah, oh, Jesus Christ, I can't write anything here.
But an absolutely fabulous performance. Oh,
Ojo was a great fan. Again, boy who has been a bit marmite. You don't expect these young players to put in performances
week in, week out.
Exactly, Ian, yeah. You know what I mean? This is it.
It's like I was really surprised yesterday to read the bit on Martin Wycombe.
I was surprised.
I knew nothing about it. Absolutely nothing about it. Suffering for his mental health problems like he did, and he was really struggling at Rangers, having to play every week, having
big
to win
game.
Every week. Big game. Aye, and
big club mentality.
And I thought, you know what, big man, I need to take my hat off to you, because we knew nothing about it. And
no.
I think the Rangers manager had let you go, didn't he? Let us know anything about it, because you could still have been with us. We could still have worked with you. We could have made this better for
but
you.
But again, I don't think Coutinho really never worked with him. He just got rid of him pretty quick.
Aye.
So wiped his hands with him. So
do you think Coutinho just said, no, he's got mental health problems, no use to me, you're out the door, we'll take the first acceptable bid? That's what kind of looked like to me, and I was not amused. You know, I wasn't amused at all. And I like Martin Wycombe. I like him as a person. I liked him as a player. And again, I was pretty gutted when he left, but understood he was moving back down south. And I thought that's what the move was for. He just wanted to go back down south. And when he got his move, his 9 million move to Derby, I thought, brilliant, good on you, mate. If a player deserves
it. And the only thing is, even if he played up until right now, I don't think he would ever have got a 9 million move from here to anywhere down south.
No, he wouldn't.
He wouldn't have. No, it's just that English thing.
Yes, absolutely.
You know, he played for a very average Ipswich side and gained that move.
Mm-hmm.
Mental illness is such a, it's a curse.
Yeah, absolutely. Again, the bad bit about it was we didn't know anything about it.
You know, there's a guy who's playing for a huge side like Rangers, and you know, pretty successful, but again, demons have inhabited his performances. You know,
again, a professional. It doesn't matter how much money you make, much your contract is. These things keep up with you. So if there's anybody out there struggling with mental health, just talk. Find somebody to talk to. Talk it out. there's always help for you. There's always somebody there to listen. So if Martin Whitehorn can do it, we can all do it.
Aye. You know, so you know, big up to the guy for coming out and laying it bare.
Absolutely. Good on him, mate. So, Martin, we wish you all the very best, mate. Still a player that we look at every week for your scores and see how you're doing and how your performances are. It was great to see you at Ibrox the other week there. So, all the best, mate. Just scrolling through Twitter, HairyJobbie Twitter land, and we said we were going to start doing Tweet of the Week and stuff, and I think it's going to be coming up in the future podcast. So, I'm just reading. I'm just reading. Dal RSC has just put on Rangers wobble against 10-man Hibs at Scottish Sun.
Right.
This is. We were sitting trying to think, what's the headlines going to be today? And I went, I can't even get my brain to think how they think. I cannot get my brain to do that. Something's going to need to happen because obviously it's way over my head and under my shoes. So, yeah. Delbert73 has just said, really happy with today's excellent performances throughout the team. Gerrard proven much of Rangers' Twitter wrong again by picking a razor-sharp Defoe and him scoring a hat-trick. Delighted. Yeah, we're going to like and retweet that, mate. That was a good tweet. I like it. Rangers had 34 attempts on goal today, 19 of them on target. That's pretty fucking incredible. That's from Tremendo Hendo, Graham Hendry. We're going to like that and retweet that as well. Can you hear the rain battering off the shed roof? Listen.
I can feel it run down my back, honestly.
That's no rain.
Oh, what?
Yeah. Somebody on Twitter getting banned for 12 hours. And then John Stewart has just commented, Corky 1873, and he's like, Tommy Sheridan grassed me and I get 12 hours just for saying the truth that he was a dogger. Oh, and lies more than separate entity FC. Like we previously, Tommy Sheridan. He challenged us to a boxing match and decided to shit out it when they found out the big game was 6'4 and 18 stone. Decided he didn't want to box anymore. Smart ass. So Tommy, get it fucking right up you. Bill Young for Rock Sport. Steven Gerrard's post-match measured, accurate and reflection of his persona now. Wanting more and wanting it consistently. Appreciated that the strength and depth is a potent weapon. Yeah, I agree with that, Bill. Like that and retweet that, mate. Heart and hand, what's Mr. Edgar saying today? But yeah. You got one for us, Colin?
Yeah, I've got Craig Corr, Craig at the top. Guy's funny. BBC, Rangers narrowly avoid embarrassment against 10-man Hibs.
For fuck's sake.
Guy's funny. H.E. Penny Parker. The guy's a legend.
What's Penny Parker said today?
Morella scores that fast, Beaton hasn't even a chance to pick him.
I love it. David out at Heart and Hand, there's 20 minutes to go, you're soaked. Jermaine Defoe's torn you a new arsehole. You look up and see Alfredo Morelos running on with that look in his face. You consider your life choices. We said that in the first half about when you turn and you're running towards the Rangers' goal. Chasing a ball.
Michael Stewart, breaking news, breaking news, it was 1544. Scott Allen has produced possibly the pass of the season already for Hibs to pull back a goal. Oh dear.
Pass of the season. Yeah.
Again, H.E. Penny Parker, Defoe will need a HIV test after pumping the Hibs back four.
That I agree with as well. So Davey says, there's 20 minutes to go, you're soaked. Jermaine Defoe is torn you a new arsehole. You look up and see Alfredo Morelos running on with that look in his face. You consider your life choices. Me and Big Colin said that in the first half. And you're running with a ball, chasing a ball towards the Rangers goal, and you can hear John Flanagan chasing behind you. You tend to question, you had to be a football player anywhere. This is going to hurt.
This is going to hurt. Even if it's fair, it's going to hurt.
Yeah.
The guy is a beast in a tackle, honestly.
I think it was the boy Horgan or O'Fargal or whatever his name is.
And again, O'Shaughnessy! I don't know.
He didn't like it. Yeah. Again, really good. The only negative, right, ruthless lady, the only negative I can take away for today is my jacket is pish and I've been as well not wearing one. Ruthless lady. You don't buy jackets for looks. You buy them for practicality.
This is sad.
It's fucking wet out there.
What was it? Was it a fur jacket, do you think?
Was it a fur jacket, Ruth? Was it? Let us know. Just message a hairy jobby and go, it was a fur jacket. I can't think you used the fur jacket type lassie, but hey, you never know. Fur might be a thing. Anything else on Twitter happening here? I'm really looking forward to Thursday.
Oh.
Mitchell and Ibrox, under the floodlights, getting into the next round. Against Legia Warsaw or that other wee team for Cyprus, I don't think they'll be looking for it to that. They'll be looking at your result and going, holy shit.
you score. It's one of the ones, you know, honestly, we're just... Wait. Again, the Kilmarnock game last week, horrible surface.
Aye.
Ibrox today with the water pissing on it was a million times better.
Yeah.
Ojo looked like he never ran on Astra's turf in his life. You know, that was how bad it was.
Yeah.
That is just, and I'm sure he has.
Aye.
But it's just a horrible, horrible surface.
Well, there's Kelly went to Hamilton Mackie's yesterday, didn't get pumped to nothing.
Aye, on Astroturf
Park.
What is this? You know, it's...
If there's ever a team deserve to get fucking pumped 2 weeks in a row, it's them.
Aye.
Well, get up them. Again, reading through your tweets this morning, Biggie, fucking hilarious. If you get a chance to go through the Hairy Jobbie Twitter account today, big comments on an hour ago. Just went to my premature ejaculation prevention class. For fuck's sake, it's the bar.
That's not even a joke.
One retweet. Sometimes
on.
You guys are at it, Dennis, because some of the super funny things he puts on, gets one and two hits, one, two digs. Some of the it's kind of all right. End up with like 200 retweets, 300 likes, half an hour, half a day of comment, knowing that he's brought Twitter to a standstill. We look at each other and go, what? Hilarious. Back to Thursday. I think we're going to be all right. I think we'll get through into the next round just watching this team, watching this squad grow. And
certainly going to be all right Thursday. Surely, God.
Aye. I would like to think so. We're trying to get a podcast together where all the boys from the Hairy Jobbie are out. We have all the equipment and everything all ready for them. But they were all here last Saturday, including Connor. But it was Conor Stag Do. Hairy Jobbie held its first ever Stag Do last week.
And its first ever UFC tournament.
I didn't win. No, you didn't.
Kind of tapped out.
I like the way you were still trying to date on me today. Let me see if I can still do this. Fuck off, I couldn't feel my horns last week. And you bit me. Right? And I like to use the heat or bite people in the UFC. You done both.
Aye.
Because you picked on you, you decided to come and pick on you. You're a big one. See if this hurts. Can it hurts? Still bruised.
Aye.
So
you should see it in a game, man. Honestly.
You think you're bruised.
I was Connor Stretch Armstrong toy.
It was when he was burying his fucking heat into your face. Right? He had you an arm bar thing and he was digging his fucking his forehead into your cheek and into your jaw.
Oh, aye.
I mean, he's going to end up burst it like a fucking an old couch. Ah, fuck him. Have another beer, boys. Think you'll be alright. You can hold his own.
I'm resilient.
Brazilian?
No, resilient.
And coming up next, we've got Mitchell and Ibrox on Thursday, and then we've got East Fife away at East Fife on Sunday, which I think will be quite an entertaining game. I expect a few changes for that game.
I expect that as well. And the first probably in goals.
Aye. And maybe
see Zach Rudden.
Maybe see Brandon Barker. I'm just quite excited. Oh! 4-0 Manchester United. Is it right that Chelsea still can't sign any players? Do you want to see? It's going to be a hard gig, man. If you can't sign fucking players, chance you got. Is that not Juan Bissaka again?
No, it was James. Somebody James.
James.
And that kid boy's name's James. There's no wee fucking stupid tick on his E. Hey, let me see.
Fucking, I don't know who he is, Colin. I've never seen that boy in my life before. Inside his own fucking 6-year box.
That is twice.
I thought Rangers were really good at counter attack, but this Man United fourth goal is just Chelsea shouldn't be losing goals like that.
Oh dear. Oh.
He done with himself.
Kicked the surface, then hit it after
defender, Dean.
The big guy's heel.
So, that just about wraps up all from the Hairy Jobbie today. Just a wee rundown of the Rangers humping, pished on of the Hibs today. So, we hope you enjoy the pished on podcast, and we will be adding more.
I'm getting pished on right now, honestly. Water is fleeing through this roof.
Ah, it's alright, you'll get the stuff tomorrow.
Honestly, you'll need to do a Rod Hull and get up on the roof.
I'm doing a Rod Hull and getting up on the roof.
He'll get a punty up.
No.
Take him away.
No. I'm not going up on your roof.
Just do it.
I'm actually looking at it, I'm going, oh shit, that is pretty. CT1, mate, CT1's the stuff you need.
Any roofers out there?
Roofer CT1, or what's that other stuff you say?
Isoflex, I don't think they make Isoflex anywhere.
CT1 is the stuff. I've used CT1 in my bathroom before. That's fucking amazing. Absolutely, it's the shizzle. Anybody knows, like, wet stuff? CT1.
Well, we all know about wet stuff. I'm wanting something to fill a gap here, Ian. Stop. It's awfully moist in here, Ian. I want something to stop this, prevent the
fucking torrential rain.
Aye.
No, mate, we'll do something. So, next time you hear from us, hopefully the hairy. Hairy. It's plunging, mate.
It's landing my eyes. I got a wee muffy.
Did you get. Oh, no. That's
quite
it.
Salty.
Hairy jobbies off. Signing out for today. Next time you hear, hopefully we'll be dry. Take care, guys. All the best.
Still probably a bit moist.
Bye, mate.
Yeah.